The structure of DNA can be hard to understand because it's hard to visualize, but it's important that students have a foundation before they learn more complex concepts. In this video, we're going to look at four ways you can use visual biology to teach DNA structures. Let's dive in. You can use visual biology's TORS feature to show students the internal structure of DNA and how DNA is stored in chromosomes. TORS are a series of views that are perfect lecturing aids. You can design a custom TOR easily. Simply access up the models and save the views you would like to use in your lecture, then create a TOR using these views. With visual biology, you can start your lecture with base pairs, move to the iconic double helix, nucleosome coiling, supercoiling, and then explore the parts of the chromosome. By the end of your TOR, students will not only have an overview of the structure of DNA, they will have a deeper understanding of its spatial context. To show students the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic chromosomes, have them navigate to the prokaryotic and eukaryotic models. Ask students to explore the models and create their own Venn diagrams that list their similarities and differences. Students will learn about these differences through tactile learning as they manipulate the models, and they will walk away with notes to study from. For this game, you can make your own flashcard deck and write prompts using the text feature, or you can use our pre-made biology flashcard decks, which asks students to identify different structures. Project the flashcard deck so that all students can see clearly and split your class into small teams. Ask each team to choose a leader to write down their answers on a small whiteboard or a piece of paper. When all groups have answered the question, flip the card by clicking on it. Did you know? Visual Biology has a YouTube series where Dr. Cindy Harley of Metropolitan State University unpacks biology content to help viewers tackle tricky concepts. You can use the flipped classroom model by having students view Lesson 1, The Structure of DNA, as a homework assignment. This frees you up to answer questions and give students individual attention during class time. Or you can kick off a conversation about science history with Lesson 4, The Discovery of DNA's Structure. I hope these ideas have inspired your lesson planning. You can request a free instructor trial to learn more about visual biology, or if you already use visual biology in your classroom, you can book a training session with the customer engagement team by following the link in the description. You can also find a link to pre-made courseware assignments based on the four ideas we talked about today. Happy teaching!